Okay, so I'm out and about, sort of. Okay. I've been effectively locked up for a couple of months due to the, I don't want to say the word, but yeah, the great elephant in the room that is that virus. But I've been running and local walking for exercise, and I'm still local walking anyway. But I thought I'll do a video, or at least I'll video it, and then it might end up on YouTube. There could be something. Well, I'm pretty sure there'll be something interesting. It's just that I never get time to put all my videos up that I do. So, do as many as I can. So I'm in Mytholmroyd, and I'm just doing a little sort of game of finding footpaths I've never walked on before. Small, awkward ones. Sort of that are tucked away, that I'd normally walk straight past, and then see how that goes. So, let's see where this one leads to. I have a feeling I'm going to be walking up quite near to them. Always a bit apprehensive around animals. Hello there. Okay, so you'll have seen from the previous clip, I'm in a spot called Hay Wood. I mean, there's no script to this walk. I've got a map, but I'm just improvising about. So I've no kind of midway destination to reach and then come back. It's just a general wander, just looking for paths I've not been on before, and this is one of them. I'm heading in the direction of Eringdon Moor, so get a general idea of where I am. And it's nice up there. Weather, I mean, the Studley Pike, just a few miles ahead. I don't know if I'll visit it, so I've visited it sort of many times, so I'll probably steer off and just improvise towards Hebden Bridge, but you never know. It's just make it up as I go along. But this is nice. Now, on the map there seems to be indications of a derelict building somewhere here. I presume it's just an old farmhouse or something similar. So hopefully we'll find that. Okay. So onward, and in this case it's upward. Okay, so just in the distance there, there's Cruttonstall Church. Okay, so I must be quite high up now. You should probably hear the wind buffeting on the camera. Well, I was just thinking, back in that wood, I said I should be passing an old barn, a derelict barn or something. Well, that it wasn't there, or I didn't see it. So I don't know, a bit of a mystery. It'll give me an excuse to go back and have another look sometime. It's called Moorside Barn. It's on the map, but I didn't see anything. I thought it was going to be obvious when I walked past, so I wasn't following the map. And then the next minute, I'm already at the top, and then I was just worried about the cows. So yeah, but there is something here that looks old. So I'm going to pass by near it. although it does look a really old barn there. According to the map, this is Rake Head. I think Cruttonstall Moor is just round about there in the distance. No, not Cruttonstall Moor, Errington Moor, what am I talking about? Just having another look at this. Okay, so we'll have another look from this side. Okay, well, I'm still wandering about. I've joined the Pennine Way footpath just for a short while. There's Studley Pike up there just behind me. Didn't fancy going up there today. So, yeah, Pennine Way, it's been a long time since I've actually been on this footpath. I have done quite a lot of it over the years, down from Edale, and I think I got as far as Ribblehead, Horton in Ribblesdale, where there's that famous viaduct, that big one, and I haven't quite got further up north for some reason, possibly because I'm a bit slack. Getting up and then not travelling too far. I hate the travel bit. I like the bit where you're actually just on your foot, because I feel free then, just on foot. So yeah, but I've watched a lot of Pennine Way videos on YouTube and it looks fantastic further up north. You got that low force, high Cupnick, then there's that pub, I forget what, the Tan Hill Inn, that's the one in the middle of nowhere. Look great, it looks hard as well. I've seen people do it all in one go and it looks quite a challenge, but I think I'm content just wandering about for now, that is. But I do keep watching everybody's videos and thinking, you know what, could do with pushing the boundaries a bit. Right, so I'm heading for close by to here, Cruttonstall. So let's see if I can remember. It's probably been about 10 years since I walked past there. Well, not to... on the move again. That building behind me, that derelict building, according to the map, it's called Cruttonstall, or the area that it's in is called Cruttonstall. Okay, so that was quite interesting. I think that was a good find. You know, I've walked this area for the last 10 years and never come across that building. That's why I like these odd walks where you just go exploring, you go around and you don't like it. So that makes up for that one that I didn't find in that bit of woodland, moorside barn, or whatever it was supposed to be called. But I'll take another look one day and see if it's me that didn't spot it. Okay, so going in this direction, and I'm just going to improvise on the map, see what there is to see. think it's Hebden Bridge. Okay, so another one of these derelict buildings. This one looks like a barn or old farmhouse. So I'm just behind it, and I'm just going to look on the map and see if there's a way I can walk past it. Okay, so I've solved the mystery of why I couldn't see Cruttonstall Church. It's because that area where all the trees are, it's further past Hebden Bridge, so I've gone a couple of miles past. It's Charlestown. Hebden Bridge is somewhere back there in the distance. Hence I can't see Cruttonstall Church Tower. So I knew there was something. Right, let's have a look on the map. I'm round at the front of the building now. There is a kind of a route that sort of goes past here, but I'm not too sure I can find it. Anyway, we'll see what happens. I'm not gonna be here all day. I'm gonna work my way out somewhere. Nice old rover here. Well, I used to have one of these. It was a lovely car. Okay, so I think I've explored enough for today. I'm pretty sure, without looking at the map, that I'm on the Pennine Way. But I'm going the other way now, as if I were going back to Studley Pike. But I'm going to turn off on a nice bit that I've walked before, but I'll film it this time. It's a Pennine Bridleway that joins onto this. But this Pennine bridle wheel take me more or less direct back down to Mytholmroyd. So yeah, so I look forward to filming that little bit because it's really nice. Okay, so you'll have just seen me have a quick can of pop, and this is the turn off, so I thought I'll have a quick drink first. And this is a nice bit. Well, it's all nice, but this is even nicer. Okay, so just making my way back and getting closer to Hebden Bridge, and now Cruttonstall Church Tower has just come into view. There it is on the horizon. Okay, so just past that big chimney there, and this is Hebden Bridge, so I'm just on a path just above it at the side, heading sort of in a Let's have a look. Easterly direction to Mytholmroyd. Okay, it's a nice view of Hebden Bridge from here. I've never been on this path before and there's no trees in the way, so it's worth another look and a zoom in. Let's see what we can see. Those look like former mills that are probably converted now into apartments. Tower there, it's probably a former mill again. It's also an unusual looking building, oh, look at that. Okay, so I'm just making my way back to Mytholmroyd. Using undiscovered footpaths, well, undiscovered for me, that is. So I keep looking around and I recognise that another time I was walking up there, And I actually did mean to come down here, so it's great. It's a great exercise for where you've strayed off a bit in the past, and then you just come back and revisit. And then no rushing, take your time, and then find those paths that you kind of missed last time. So it's been great. I think the highlights, apart from all the great woodland and stuff, it's got to be that those couple of derelict buildings in particular. The one that on the map it says Cruttonstall, whatever place that is. I mean, Cruttonstall, there isn't that much there really, except that old derelict barn. But it's quite a farmhouse with barn. It's quite a substantial building really, and you can imagine its heyday. It would have been, well, it would have been important to the owner that lived and worked there. Okay, so I don't know how much more I'm going to see along the way, so I'm still on the nitty-gritty footpaths, and I've still got one or two to find, so I'll probably switch on one more time and then we'll see after that. And I think sometimes I can't keep my gob short. I've tried to speak less today than I normally do and film more of the surroundings rather than filming me. Okay, let's keep going. Nearly done. Just wonder what this was. Was used for in times past. Look, it's got a little hole there with like a sliding chute. Is that to let water out? Is this just like a retaining wall or part of a former building? I haven't a clue. Some brickwork on both sides of it, here as well, that extends up. Although the brickwork does look like it was meant to be just a wall, perhaps. It's got some finishing off stones placed on top. I don't know. Could be just a retaining wall. Well, look at that, for a majestic front. There's an even better view here. Wow. Okay, well, I'm about half an hour to 45 minutes, I think, away from where I've parked up at Mytholmroyd. So my battery warning light's come on, so thank you very much for watching. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you on my next walk, all being well. Okay, cheers.